Hi children, welcome to science class. Are you feeling bored to play with the routine playthings? Then come, here is a new toy for you I am introducing to play in a different way. Are you ready to play? Yes, let us play with the new things. So here you are going to learn about playing with magnets. Playing with magnets. Do you know magnets? I hope everybody know about magnets. But how to play with magnets? Let us see in the lesson. Shall we start? Yes. In this lesson, we will be discussing the types of magnets, and we will differentiate the magnetic and non-magnetic substances. We will explain the working of a magnetic compass. And we also find the geographical directions using a simple magnet. And we will build our own magnet and magnetic compass. And we will also describe the magnetic induction property. Okay? Let us learn through this lesson all these learning objectives. So, you have to be eager to learn all these. Okay, children? Have you ever seen these objects? First one is pin holder and the second one is iron almirah. We have seen some pins attached to the top or cap of a pin holder in our school office or somewhere else. And also we might have seen some metal stickers stuck to the door of an iron almirah or a refrigerator. Have you observed like this? Do you know how the pins are attached to the cap of the pin holder? Or do you know how the metal stickers are stuck to the iron almirah? Let us try to find the answers and understand the reasons in detail. To learn about this, let's do an activity. Okay? Take a pin holder and drop some pins, jump clips, iron nails, a pencil and an eraser into it or any other things. If you wish. Okay? Observe the changes. What happened? What are you noticing on this? Pins are attached to the rod and jump clips also attached to the rod, iron nails attached to the rod. But a pencil and an eraser, are they attached? No, they are just at the bottom of the cup, right? So if you see separately in this activity, we observe that some of these objects like pins, jump clips and iron nails stuck to the top of the pin holder, while the other objects like paper, pencil, eraser fall into the pin holder. Why? What is the reason like this happening? The iron things are attached to the pin holder, whereas remaining all the things, they do not stick to the pin holder. So from this we can learn the cap of the pin holder contains a material known as magnet, which attracts substances like iron pins, iron nails, etc. or jump clips. In the same way, the metal sticks also have a magnet as their back so that they can stick to the iron doors. In the first to second activity in iron almirah, the badge or something will stick to the iron almirah door. So why it is sticking? Because it is also having some magnetic property which is attracted by the magnet. So this is the reason that some iron things are attracted towards the magnet, whereas these pencil and eraser not stick to the magnet. When you heard about a magnet, you can imagine different shaped magnets. See here, it is called bar magnet. What is this? Bar magnet. And this is called horseshoe magnet. Horseshoe magnet. And this is ring magnet. Ring magnet. This one, disc magnet. Disc magnet. So in our daily life, we see different shapes of magnets. Some of the usual shapes of magnets are bar magnet, horseshoe magnet, ring magnet, and disc magnet. These are the magnets we see generally in our daily lives. Usually, magnets are made of steel or iron. They are made up of steel or iron. However, special alloys of iron, nickel, copper, cobalt, and aluminium can be used to make into powerful magnets. Some magnets are made of special alloys, with the special alloys like iron, nickel, copper, cobalt, and aluminium. Okay, so these are the things in the usage or in the preparation of magnets. At present, we are using neodymium. The strongest magnet currently known is neodymium. All of you say, children, neodymium. The strongest magnet which currently is known, neodymium. Neodymium is the strongest magnet. Here we have an interesting story about inventing magnet in your textbooks. You might have seen that a person, a shepherd, he was named Magnus. His name Magnus. Around 2500 years ago, he was a shepherd, and his name Magnus. He used to take his goats for the grazing. So he always carried a wooden stick. He always carried a wooden stick in his hands, which is having an iron cap on its lower end. At the end of the stick, he has an iron stick. Okay. So, one day while his goats were grazing, Magnus dipped his stick into a spring of water and poked at the pebbles and stones at the bottom with it. Just he is poking with the stick. Then suddenly he felt something pulling his stick. While he is trying to pull his stick, it is not coming, because someone else or something else attracting the stick. So he observed that, or he noticed that when he took it out of water, he saw a stone stuck to the iron cap. A stone stuck to the iron cap. The stone which Magnus pulled out was called lodestone. What is that stone is called? Lodestone. So it is a natural magnet and possesses the property of attracting iron. So the first person was invented magnet is Magnus. So by his name, that lodestone is called as magnet. That was the first magnet invented by that shepherd Magnus. So the name also given by his name as magnet. See, he was a simple shepherd. He was not a scientist also, but his observation made him as a scientist, and his name is given to the material as a magnet. By the name of Magnus, the material or the substance called as magnet. Is it really interesting? Yes. So our observation makes us different. Always our observation makes us different. See, we knew about Sir Isaac Newton, right? So Newton was a common boy, a common student. He was always rejected by his class and class teacher. But his observation always different. While he was sitting under an apple tree, the apple fell down. So what do we do generally? If an apple fell down, what do we do, children? Simply we eat it and we forget about that. But he was thinking that why apple fell down? Have you ever thought like that? No, we never thought like that. But his different way of thinking made him as a scientist. So that his thinking, his powerful thinking and his more hard work made him as a scientist. He invented new things. Okay, so like that, children, we also should have such kind of concentration and focus. Whatever work we are doing, we should have such an icon. We should have such an interest, then we can invent or we can know many things. Okay, children, so this is about the story of magnet inventing. So let us learn about different kinds of shaped magnets and magnetic properties. All these things let us see. So for this activity you have to collect some objects like pen, bottle, jump clips or paper clips, book, coin and key. Okay, take a bar magnet. Now touch the each object with the bar magnet. Touch the each object with the bar magnet and observe the changes. What happened? Does the pen touch the magnet? No. Bottle? No. Jump clips? Yes. Book? No. Coin? Yes. And key? Yes. So what did you notice? So from this activity we can observe that some of these objects like jump clips, coin and key get attracted to the bar magnet, while the other objects, pen, bottle and book, eraser, pencil, they do not attract to the bar magnet. So see here, a table form is given, name of the object is written and material of which the object is made is written. Attracted by the magnet, if it is attracted you should write yes, if not you have to write no. You can see here, pen is made of plastic, right? So does it attract by the magnet? Did it attract by the magnet? No. Bottle, it's made of glass, it is also not attracted by the magnet. Jump clips, made up of iron, it is attracted towards the magnet. Book, made of wood pulp, right? So it is not attracted. No. Coin, made up of nickel, it is attracted towards the magnet. And key, made up of iron, and it is also get attracted by the magnet. Yes. Thus we can give a conclusion that we learned the materials that are attracted by magnets are called magnetic materials. The materials which attracted by the magnets are called magnetic materials, like iron, nickel and cobalt. The materials that are not attracted by magnets are called non-magnetic materials, like plastic, wood and paper. Okay, magnets have the property of attracting materials like iron. We knew about that. Always magnet attracts iron. Based on this property of magnets, they are used to separate some mixtures. So magnets are used to separate some mixtures. How do they separate? Let's see. So from the previous activity we can classify like magnetic substances or non-magnetic substances. See which comes under magnetic substances: iron key, jump clip, iron nail, right? And which comes under non-magnetic substances? Wood, pen, bottle or book. Yes or no? So these are the things that are magnetic substances and these are the things that non-magnetic substances. Let us do another activity that is about separation of iron filings from soil or sand. So collect some sand or soil in a bowl. Take a bar magnet and roll it in the soil for some time. What happens? Observe the bar magnet. See, something stuck to the iron magnet, right? Something stuck to the bar magnet. What is that? We observe here some particles of sand or soil stick to the magnet. Through this activity, we can find that whether the soil or sand contain iron particles. So we conclude that the iron filings, if they are present in the soil, they stick to the magnet rubbed in the soil or sand. Okay, whatever the soil we have taken here. So when we rub bar magnet in the soil or sand, so if there are some iron filings in the soil or sand, they stick to the magnet while rubbing. So I told you playing with the magnets, right? So take a bar magnet or some other magnet, whatever, horseshoe magnet or ring magnet or disc magnet, whatever magnet you have, You can do this. You can collect iron filings. How much iron is collected? You can play with this. You can form in different shapes also. As you are moving of the magnet, along with the magnet, the iron filings also will move with the attraction. So try this, children, and you also would love this game to enjoy. Let us learn about the poles of magnet. Poles of bar magnet. Let us see poles of bar magnets. How can we notice about poles of bar magnets? Let us see. Take some iron filings like this, whatever you collected in the previous activity, and spread them uniformly on a table. Now take a bar magnet and place it on the table for some time. What do you observe? See, iron filings attracted towards the poles. So in this activity, we observe that more iron filings get attracted towards the two ends of a bar magnet, and we will also find some scattered iron filings between the two ends of a bar magnet, right? See, at the poles. Poles means at the end points, there are more iron filings, whereas in the middle zone or the middle of the bar magnet, there are less iron filings. Have you noticed it? Yes. So finally, we conclude that every bar magnet always has two ends whose attracting capacity is more than its other parts. So these ends are called poles, poles of the magnet, poles of the bar magnet. These are called poles of the bar magnet. Okay, we learnt about poles of the bar magnet. What are that poles? Which poles are there? Let us see through this activity, and in which direction that poles will be there, we will find through an activity. So for this activity, you required a retort stand on the table. Take a bar magnet and tie a thread at the middle of the bar magnet, at the exact middle. Now suspend it freely from the retort stand and wait until the bar magnet comes to rest. Okay, check what is happening. Observe the directions of the bar magnet. Now disturb the magnet and again wait until it comes to rest. See what is happening. Again it would stop in the same directions. Once again observe the directions of the bar magnet. Repeat the same process for 3 times or more times until you get clarity. So we observe that a freely suspended bar magnet always comes to rest in a particular same direction, which is the north-south direction. Which is the north-south direction. That's why we say for magnet, north pole, south pole. Do you remember it? North pole, south pole. So here we observe that a freely suspended bar magnet always comes to rest in a particular same direction, in north-south direction. North-south direction. So we learned that the end of the magnet that points towards geographical north is called its north pole of the magnet, and the other end that points towards the geographical south is known as south pole of the magnet. North pole of the magnet, south pole of the magnet. So this property of magnets is called directional property. What is this property of magnets called, ma? Directional property. It is exhibited only by magnets. It is exhibited only by magnets. We use this property to make the magnetic compass. For what purpose we use it? To make the magnetic compass. So this is called magnetic compass. A compass is usually a small box with a glass covering it and consists of a small pointed magnet which is suspended freely. And a freely suspended magnet always aligns in north-south directions. North-south directions. The red colored magnetic needle points to north direction. The red colored magnetic needle points to north direction. Once we know north direction, we can easily find out the other directions. North opposite side is south, right? So right side is east direction and west side is west direction. So we can point out, if we know one direction, by using that we can identify remaining three directions. How many directions we have? Four, right? North, south, east, west. So we can identify the remaining three if we know north direction. So by using magnetic compass we will notice them. So for what purpose we use this? It is used to find directions. It is mostly used in ships and airplanes, mountaineers and army people also carry a compass with them so that they do not lose their way in unknown place. If they lost their way by using compass, they can find their way back. How can they find their way back? For example, if they are going in east direction, suddenly they missed their way in a forest or in ocean. So by using compass, again they can get back to their way by using this compass, because compass always shows the directions. So it is very helpful for them. But don't place compass and magnets together. If you place magnet and compass together, with the magnetic effect, the compass needle will be deflected. For example, it is a compass. So if you place here magnet, what will happen? With the effect of magnet, the compass needle will rotate, so that the deflection, whatever the change in deflection, movement of the needle will be changed. So it may be get confusion. So while you are using compass, we should not keep magnet and compass together. It should be both each away from each other. So the compass was used hundreds of years ago by Chinese sailors. Recently, many of the people are using. But before hundreds of years, Chinese sailors means the people who sailed by boats or ships, they used before 100 years ago. So in our first part of playing with magnets, we learnt about magnet, right? Magnet and the story of the magnet. And what is the strongest magnet currently known? Neodymium. And a person named Magnus invented the magnet. And we came to know about magnets of different shapes, like bar magnet, horseshoe magnet, ring magnet and disc magnet. And we also find that why magnets are attracting the iron filings like that. That means the substances which are having magnetic properties are attracted by the magnets, whereas which they don't have magnetic properties, they are not attracted by the magnets.